Hi, I'm Peggy Dembiser. I'm going to walk you through some of the steps it took to make this vessel. This is an open weaved vessel that's done with a bunch of variegated yarns. And I'm going to talk about the materials that I used and the process that I used. What I needed was oats and rice, or any kind of small grain, plastic bag, which I filled with the contents of this basket, of this bucket, and then double face tape. So once I fill the plastic bag with the small grains, and then I seal it up with a twist tie, and then I take double face tape. There's a number of different brands. You can get a thicker tape on the market, and I wrap the whole plastic bag with the double face tape. And then I take fiber and I completely wrap the plastic bag and the double face tape every which way, all around, up, down, sideways, covering the entire surface with threads. Once I've done that, that is the form that is basically this vessel. I've left a little, so when I wrap the fiber around the plastic bag, I leave a small opening in the top, which is where I'm going to be able to withdraw the plastic, dump the contents of the plastic bag out, withdraw the plastic bag and tape, and have a freestanding vessel that is sort of defies logic when you look at it, because you can see how small the opening is. How was this formed? So that the opening on this vessel is very tiny. I can barely get my hand in. If I squeeze my hand, really, I can get in there, which helped me to unbag the contents earlier. But other than that, you know, it's almost a complete sphere. And so, like I said, you just need some fiber, some tape, some small grains. Once you have the vessel, the plastic bag wrapped, you need a blunt needle, because that's what you're going to put your fiber into, the blunt tip, and then you're going to successively wrap around bundles of threads and layer them and create these openings, these web-like openings. And there's a little video that will show you that process as I'm working. So this is a vessel that I'm working on, and there, inside of the vessel, there's a plastic bag full of steel-cut oats and rice, making a large form that's, you know, sealed with zip ties. I took thread. This began with workshops with Jody Colella with the Surface Design Association. She was demonstrating this technique. I wrapped the plastic bag with double face tape. So the tape is taped to the plastic bag, but also taped to threads that I've wrapped around in a web formation all around the form. And it was just random brown threads. And then the next step is to gather those threads into coils. So I've done that with a variety of threads. I've gathered the threads into coils. What I'm doing is digging under with a blunt needle, so I don't want to pierce the bag if I can help it. And I'm going to just keep wrapping around the brown threads that are on top of the form until I've completely covered. What I'm trying to do is gather this sort of haphazard mess of threads into strips, you know, strips that form a loose web. And once I'm done with this, once all the threads from the basic wrap are wrapped and coiled, I will then open the bag and take out the filling and pull the plastic bag out of the form and have an open vessel with nothing in it that should stand on its own. So I'm going to continue wrapping the strip. Okay, so suppose I was at the end of this thread and I wanted to end it. I take this loop of a strong piece of thread and I lay it here and then I wrap around a couple of times. I can make sure this loop stays out where I can see it and know that I'm continuing to wrap over it. Let's go one more. Okay, I'm just going to take this tail and I'm going to put it through the loop like this, and then I'm just going to pull this, and now I've hidden the end of that thread and I can clip it. Okay. So I finished wrapping the entire basket. So I'm going to undo this zip tie, actually, and dump this stuff out. Ooh, I hope this bowl is big enough. Whoops, maybe not.
Pause.
Got a bigger bowl now. I'm sure more than I need. That's a lot of rice and oats. Okay. Okay. So that's done. Now I'll move these aside. Try to get this plastic bag out of here. Might not be as easy as I thought. I'm going to get my hand in there if I can and break it up. Let's see about squeezing this out. I might have to cut this into pieces. Let me try twisting it. I'm getting there. Okay, now if I can get in here and actually plump this out. I think I get in here with a stick or something and really push it. But you can see that it's a freestanding vessel, just needs to be shaped.